Rahul Gandhi accused the government, well, Modi Shah, the incoming government, of being in cahoots with exit pollsters and TV news channels to rig the markets. Since you have been in finance in your previous avatar to being a politician, do you agree with him?
Yeah, I agree with him. But one slight correction. Before Rahul did the press conference, and he did a good press conference, not taking away from that. On the 5th, just the day after the election, the Trinamool's Rajya Sabha MP Saket Gokhale wrote to SEBI. So we actually put out the first letter saying that this was a complete scam where you had a sitting finance minister and a sitting prime minister and the home minister telling people to buy equities. This was absolutely insane. And the prime minister gave an interview to NDTV, which is Adani's channel, and who's got the most shady investors on the planet, and so when they found electoral bonds can no longer be used, they figured out, let's just get 5-10,000 crores via the pollsters and their owners, and that's exactly it.
Saying all of the pollsters were in cahoots? What is the specific allegation?
Look, the specific allegations were, how could it be? So let's look at the big houses. Who are the big houses? So not if you're looking at some little pollster who's not a public company, that's okay. If you're looking at the big pollsters, and you know which ones I am, the top three, and you see the ones he gave interviews to, the top three are publicly public limited companies who were playing the stock market. And look at their share prices. And they use the pollsters. The pollsters obviously said that the Modi's coming back. Modi said, I'm coming back, not only coming back with 400. They used the exit polls to tell people that this government is coming back when it was not, to tell people we're coming back with absolute majority, and they built the thing up so all their cronies could buy on the upswing.
You spoke about Adani. I'll come back to the exit polls, but you spoke about Adani. But the BJP has been sharing how West Bengal is just commissioned a big Adani project. And they say that this is contradictory.
We have no problem.
The opposition attacks Adani nationally, but at the state level, they welcome Adani's companies with open arms.
You're getting me wrong. There is no problem. Adani is a company. If there is a bid and he plays by the rules and he's a bidder in there, I'm not stopping anybody, neither is West Bengal. So if he's bidding for a project and getting it, we don't have a problem if he's one of any. If he has no pre-qualification to bid for airports and the law specifically requires you to have operated airports before you can bid for it, then how does he get airports? My question is that. My question is, how does he get Dhamra and then IOC and GAIL enter into a long-term offtake agreement with him? So we have specific questions regarding this coal. This coal scam is the biggest scam ever. He's been buying a low-grade coal, 3,500 grade coal from Indonesia and selling it as 6,000 environmentally high grade coal to state power companies, as a result of which you and I are all paying high electricity prices. So we have a problem with that. If Adani is doing a project like any other corporate and is bidding for a project, be it in Bengal, be it in UP, be it in Rajasthan, we have no problem with it.
Let's come back to the Sensex and the exit polls for a moment. The BJP argument is that the markets were volatile because the markets thought it was going to be a BJP government and it turned out to be a coalition government, and the markets don't like the coalition government, and that's why they crashed.
One minute.
And so it's the organic market volatility.
So why? Listen, why do the markets think that the BJP is coming back suddenly?
Because
with this
of the exit
thing?
Polls.
And what are the exit polls? Each of the exit polls was paid for by the BJP. Every single exit poll was paid for by the BJP. I can say that on record.
What is your basis to say that?
What do you expect? They're all run by the Godi media. Every single one of them were run. They had no methodology. Nobody put out any methodology. How could either they're all rubbish? Look, one exit poll has to get it right. All of the ones which are the Godi media, which are the Noida channels, every single one got it wrong. How could they get it? That means they're anyway worthless. Look, either one of two things. Either they got it wrong because they're stupid, in which case they're irrelevant anyway and they shouldn't be in this business. No. Or they got it wrong because they were paid to get it wrong. Yeah. And to create the impression of, psyching everyone out so they could get that last minute flourish. So either way, they don't deserve to.
Did these elections render legacy media irrelevant?
I'm so glad you call them legacy media. I hope they've rendered them irrelevant, but they're completely shameless. I've seen them now. And they're trying to balance themselves.
They might pivot now, right? They might pivot.
They might do anything, but I think we know what they're all about. So they're not going to find it so easy to brown nose us now.